Hello students, welcome to this online class of mathematics for class 7 conducted by your math teacher Manju Malik. Topic of today's class is algebra, fundamental concepts of algebra of your math book, essential ICSE mathematics. Students, you are already familiar with the basic terms and concepts of algebra. Let us revise what we have learned. Literals and constants. A symbol used to represent an unspecified number is called a literal or variable. The small letters A, B, C, X, Y, Z, etc. of English alphabet are generally used to indicate a variable. Numbers like 2, minus 3 and 0 are called constants, because they have a fixed or constant value. So, variable is a quantity that can change or vary. In mathematics, we use letters to represent variables. And constant is a quantity that does not change. An expression in a mathematical phrase involving constants, variables, and operation symbols. Term. A term is a name given to a number, a variable, or a number and a variable combined by multiplication or division. So, in algebraic expression A plus 2, the terms are A and 2. 3m plus 6n minus 6, it contains three terms, 3m, 6n and minus 6. Like terms and unlike terms. Like terms that have the same power of same variable are called like terms, for example 3x and 2x. Unlike terms that do not contain the same power of the same variable are called unlike terms, for example 3x and 3y. Algebraic expression. A combination of numbers and variables resulting from one or more of the operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division is called an algebraic expression. So, an expression that consists of one or more variables, it can contain some constants and some variables. For example, 2x plus 3y plus 6. 5n, a minus b, these are all algebraic expressions. Polynomials in one variable. An algebraic expression is called a polynomial in one variable if the literal factor of each of its term is a positive power of the variable. Such an expression can contain a constant term. The index of the power of the variable is the constant term is 0, because x raised to power 0 is 1. So, a polynomial in the variable x can have constant and positive powers of x such that x, x square and x cube in its terms. The highest power of the variable appearing in any of the terms of the polynomial is called the degree of the polynomial. So, we can see polynomials in one variable with the help of the examples. Consider the polynomial minus 2x5 plus 8x cube minus 6x square plus 3x plus 1. Now, the terms of the polynomials are minus 2x5, 8x cube, minus 6x square, 3x and 1. The coefficients of 1, x, x square, x cube and x5 are 1, 3, minus 6, 8, and 2 respectively. The leading coefficient of the polynomial is minus 2. The degree of the polynomial is 5. A polynomial is made up of terms that are only added, subtracted, or multiplied. Polynomial comes from poly, that means many. In this case, it means terms. So it says many terms. So a polynomial can have many terms. Now we will discuss about the degree of a polynomial. The highest power of the variable appearing in any of the terms of the polynomial is called the degree of the polynomial, or we can say the degree of a polynomial is the highest exponent value of any of its terms. The degree of a term is the sum of the exponents of the variable it contains. For example, 3x plus 2 is a polynomial in x. The degree of the polynomial is 1. There are two terms in the polynomial. 5x square minus 7x plus 3 upon 2 is a polynomial in x of degree 2. The indices of the power of x in the three terms are 2, 1 and 0 respectively. As highest power is 2, so the degree of the polynomial is 2. Similarly, in 1 upon 2y cube plus 5y minus 5 upon 3, the degree of the polynomial is 3, as the highest power of y is 3. In polynomials with more than one variable, add the exponents for each term together. For example, in 2x cube y square, add the powers of x and y, that is 3 plus 2, so the exponent of the term is 5. Similarly, 3xy minus 2 is equal to 3 has the degree 2, as x has 1 and y has also 1. 2x square plus 3xy square is equal to 5y. The degree is 3, as x has 1 and y has 2. Similarly, 3x cube plus 4y plus 2x square y square has degree 4, as x has 2 and y has also 2. Now, when the degree is 0, it is a constant. When the degree is 1, it is called linear equation. When the degree is 2, it is a quadratic equation. Similarly, with degree 3 cubic, degree 4 quartic, and degree 5 quintic. We are familiar with the fundamental operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of numbers. So we can extend these operations into algebraic expressions also. So now we will learn about addition of algebraic expressions. Addition of like terms. The sum of two or more like terms is another like term, the coefficient of which is the sum of the coefficients of the like terms. For example, 5a plus 7a is equal to 5 plus 7 into a, 12a. Similarly, 2a plus minus 4a is equal to 2 plus minus 4 into a, that is minus 2a. Addition of unlike terms. Unlike terms cannot be added. We just write them along with their signs to form an algebraic expression. For example, the sum of minus 9x and 16y is minus 9x plus 16y. Now, addition of two or more algebraic expression can also be done by two methods. There are two ways of adding algebraic expressions, the horizontal method and the column method. Horizontal method, connect all the expressions by plus signs, collect the like terms in groups, add the terms in each group, write the unlike terms along with their signs to form an algebraic expression. For example, 7xy plus 5yz minus 3zx plus 4yz plus 9zx minus 4y plus minus 2xy minus 3zx plus 5x. By opening the bracket and bringing the like terms together, we get 7xy minus 2xy plus 5yz plus 4yz minus 3zx plus 9zx minus 3zx plus 5x minus 4y. So we get 5xy plus 9yz plus 3zx plus 5x minus 4y. The second method is column method. Write the expressions one below the other so that the like terms fall in the same column. Add the terms in each column and then add the result what we are getting. So 7xy plus 5yz minus 3zx. Below that, 4yz will be below the yz term plus 9zx below the zx term minus 4y separate. Minus 2xy below the xy term minus 3zx below the zx term plus 5x separate. So adding all, we get 5x plus 9yz plus 3zx plus 5x minus 4y. Subtraction of algebraic expressions. To subtract a literal y from another literal x, we add the negative of y, that is minus y, to x. Similarly, we subtract an algebraic expression from another. Negative of an algebraic expression. To find the negative of a monomial, we change the sign of the coefficient of the monomial. Subtracting an algebraic expression from another. As in the case of addition, there are also two ways of subtracting an algebraic expression from another, the horizontal method and the column method. Horizontal method. To subtract an algebraic expression from another, add the negatives of the first expression to the second. In other words, we can say, change the sign of each of the terms of the first expression and proceed as in the case of addition. Similarly, column method, write the subtrahend, that means the expression to be subtracted, below the expression from which the subtrahend to be subtracted, such that the like terms are in the same column. Change the sign of the each term of the subtrahend and add the two algebraic expressions, as you can see in the example. 12a minus 9ab plus 5b minus 3. 4a minus 7ab plus 3b plus 12. Now change the sign of the subtrahend. Plus 12 will become minus 12. 3b will become minus 3b. Minus 7ab will become plus 7ab. 4a will become minus 4a. And add them. So we are getting 8a minus 2ab plus 2b minus 15. Similarly, in horizontal method, 12a minus 9ab plus 5b minus 3 in bracket minus the second term, 4a minus 7ab plus 3b minus 12. Now open the bracket, 12a minus 9ab plus 5b minus 3 minus 4a plus 7b minus 3b minus 12. And adding the like terms together, we get 8a minus 2ab plus 2b minus 15. Multiplication of algebraic expressions. Multiplication of algebraic expression most commonly has the same pattern for most of its types. For example, multiplication of two monomials. Product of two monomials is equal to product of their numerical coefficients into product of their literal coefficients. Multiplication of a binomial by a monomial. Multiply each term of the binomial by the monomial and add all the products. Multiplying monomials. To multiply monomials, multiply coefficients and add the exponents with the same bases. Multiplying polynomials. To multiply two polynomials, we multiply each monomial of one polynomial with its sign by each monomial with its sign of the other polynomial. Write these products one after the other with their signs and then add the like monomials to form the complete product. Linear equations and inequations. What is linear equation? A statement of equality of two algebraic expressions in or more variables is called an equation. Every equation has a left hand side, the equality sign, and the right hand side. The value of x, that is some number for x which makes the equation a true statement, is called solution or root of the equation. To solve an equation, for example, x plus 4 is equal to 10. Now subtracting 4 from both the sides, we get x plus 4 minus 4 is equal to 10 minus 4. So this gives you x is equal to 6. Similarly, y minus 6 is equal to 5. Adding 6 both the sides, we get y minus 6 plus 6 is equal to 5 plus 6. So y is equal to 11. Now another method is transposing method. In an equation, an added term is transposed or taken from one side to the other, it is subtracted. For example, x plus 4 is equal to 10, then x is equal to 10 minus 4, that is 6. Here 4 is transposed. In an equation, a subtracted term is transposed to the other side, it is added. Y minus 6 is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. Here 6 is transposed. In an equation, a term in multiplication is transposed to the other side, it is divided. 3x is equal to 12. X is equal to 12 divided by 3. 3 is transposed. In an equation, a term in division is taken to the other side, is multiplied. Y upon 4 is equal to 6, y is equal to 6 into 4, 4 is transposed. More examples of solving linear equation. 3x plus 8 is equal to 14, 3x is equal to 14 minus 8, transposing 8, 3x is equal to 6, x is equal to 6 upon 3, transposing 3, and we are getting x is equal to 2. Another example, 12x plus 30 plus 8x minus 6 is equal to 10, 20x plus 24 is equal to 10, 20x plus 24 minus 24 is equal to 10 minus 24, 20x is equal to minus 14, 20x divided by 20 is equal to minus 14 by 20, so x is equal to minus 7 upon 10. So a linear equation can be written in the form ax plus b, where a, b and c are real numbers, and addition property of equality is a is equal to b, and a plus c is equal to b plus c, and multiplication property of equality is a is equal to b and ac is equal to bc. So we can see another example of linear equation. 5 3 plus z minus in bracket 8z plus 9 is equal to minus 4z. Opening the bracket, we get 15 plus 5z minus 8z minus 9 is equal to minus 4z. And solving both the sides, we get 6 plus z is equal to 0 and z is equal to minus 6. Verification of the solution. A solution of a linear equation in one variable is a real number which, when substituted for the variable in the equation, makes the equation true. For example, is 3 a solution of 2x plus 3 is equal to 11? We put the value of 3 in both the sides and we see that left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So, 3 is not a solution of 2x plus 3 is equal to 11. Another example, is 4 a solution of 2x plus 3 is equal to 11? We put the value of x there, 2 into 4 plus 3 is equal to 11, 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. So, left hand side we are getting 11 and right hand side is already 11. Therefore, 4 is a solution of 2x plus 3 is equal to 11. So, students, today we have learned about literals and constants, algebraic expressions like and unlike terms, degree of the polynomial, addition, subtraction, and multiplication of algebraic expressions, linear equations, solution of the linear equation, rule of transposition, and verification. I hope this all will help you to understand the concept of algebra. Thank you.